With an increasing concentration of greenhouse gases in our atmosphere due to fossil fuels, the implementation of renewable energy is as important as ever. Among these include solar and wind power to power our domestic application. Among these sources include biogas. Biogas is a carbon-neutral source composed of carbon dioxide and methane produced by the anaerobic digestion of manure, organic waste, and sludge. These wastes are mixed into a biogas reactor for further treatment.
One of the main byproducts of municipal water plants is sludge. Sludge is composed of more than 95% bacteria. Sludge is also composed of higher organisms, such as protozoa. Metazoa. Fungi. And algae.
The ecosystem for anaerobic digestion is mainly composed of facultative and obligate anaerobes. One major group is named acidogenic bacteria as they produce organic acids out of the sludge carbohydrates. Another group is the methanogens. They are archaea that produce biogas from the organic acids. The anaerobes can perform sludge digestion at cryophilic or thermophilic range. However, the mesophilic range is conventional for an acceptable digestion rate and energy input. For anaerobic sludge digestion to happen, a minimal COD concentration of 1,500 g per cubic meter is required. Ammoniacal nitrogen concentration should be above 50 g per cubic meter, but below 1,500 g per cubic meter to avoid inhibition of the methanogenesis. Phosphorus content should be higher than 10 g per cubic meter. Sulfur should be kept at a range between 35 to 50 g per cubic meter to maintain bacterial growth and methanogenesis. Some heavy metals should be kept below a limit as shown below. The pH should be kept as neutral as possible. Once all conditions are met, the sludge will be firstly hydrolyzed by the exoenzymes secreted by the bacteria into simple sugars, amino acids, and long-chain fatty acids. Then, these intermediate products are further transformed into alcohols, volatile fatty acids, ammonium acetate with inorganic hydrogen gas, carbon dioxide, and hydrogen sulfide by acetogenesis. The acetogens then convert alcohol and volatile fatty acids into acetic acids while producing more hydrogen gas and carbon dioxide. Finally, the methanogens uses acetic acid, hydrogen gas, and carbon dioxide to generate biogas. The digester can be designed as a shallow cylindrical tank, a tall cylindrical tank, or an egg-shaped tank. In general, cylindrical design has less efficient mixing and promotes scum and foam accumulation. In contrast, egg-shaped reactor is cleaner of scum and foam, more efficient in mixing, but may require additional biogas storage tanks and sophisticated construction. A suspended growth single-stage digester is the conventional technology applied for anaerobic sludge digestion. The sludge is fed into the digester and get completely mixed. The lighter gas will be collected on the reactor's top, whereas the sludge is reduced by 40 to 50% of its total solids after 30 minutes to 24 hours, depending on the loading rate.
Because waste from agriculture, wastewater, and domestic wastes are available all over the world, biogas is an attractive alternative to fossil fuels. Biogas can be produced domestically, and it is a relatively low-cost option with an efficiency ranging from 60 to 70%. While improving waste management and nutrient control, it also reduces methane and CO2 emissions from landfills. Depending on the input of biomass chosen, the composition of biogas can range from 50% to 80% methane and 20 to 50% carbon dioxide. On a small scale, the biogas can be used for cooking, heating, and electricity. However, on a large scale, the biogas can be put into a combined heat power system to provide electricity to be injected into a grid. For transport, however, the biogas must be upgraded to biomethane by removing CO2 to make the composition 95% methane. After digestion, a byproduct known as slurry is produced. The slurry is rich in nitrogen, phosphorus, and potassium, making it a good candidate for fertilizer. Furthermore, the slurry is free of weed seeds and can improve the NPK ratio of the soil.
A Montreal company by the name of Biometatech specializes in conceptualization, planning, engineering, and design of biogas installations. The following pictures are examples of projects that they have worked on or they have consulted.
In Sweden, roughly 12,000 vehicles run on biogas alone, including municipal buses and trains. In Europe, a little less than 200,000 gigawatt hours of electricity is produced per year, while Germany produces more than 70,000 gigawatt hours per year alone. Biogas also has the potential to create 250,000 jobs in the US and remove 146 million metric tons of CO2 from the air annually.